respected Father Stan and all my dear friends. Today, me and my team are here to strengthen your knowledge about demonetization. Good morning, my name is Muskan Morandani.
My name is Muskan Mullani.
My name is
Madali.
My name is Lavanya Mathur.
My name is
Bieda Soni. Demonetization is the act of stripping a currency unit of its status as legal tender. It occurs whenever there is a change in national currency. The current form of or forms of money is pulled from circulation and retired, often to be replaced from new notes or coins. Sometimes a country replaces the old currency with new currency. So, as we all know, at the time of demonetization, it was out by media that the demonetization was a secret affair between three people. The Mr. Narendra Modi, Prime Minister of India. Second, Mr. Arun Jaitley, Finance Minister of India. Third, Mr. Urjit Patel, RBI Governor. Hence, is in India, it was demonetization or remonetization? Anyone here? It was a demonetization or remonetization? It was both. Because the in rupees, 1,000 rupees note, the whole currency was changed. In that case, rupees 2,000 rupees notes were declared. But instead of rupees 500 notes, a new note of 500 note was declared, and that is known as remonetization. There in India, three demonetization took place till now. First, in the year 1946, rupees 500 note, rupees 1,000, rupees 10,000 notes were demonetization under British rule. Second, in the year 1978, rupees 5,000, rupees 10,000 notes were demonetized under the Janata Dal government. Third, in year 2016, rupees 500 and rupees 1,000 notes were demonetized under the government of Mr. Narendra Modi. Thank you. Now my friend Lavanya will carry on the presentation.
So, who do you think is an entrepreneur? Anybody here? Anyone? An entrepreneur is a person who sets up a business or businesses taking financial risk in order to achieve profit. Do you think that PM Modi is an entrepreneur? Well, if you think so, then you're almost there. He is a pioneer. A pioneer is a changer, a trendsetter, a person who sets a country, who sets an area. PM Modi, as an entrepreneur, has taken India as a business to various heights in various fields. He, with his innovation, has made sure that India prospers. It took 70 years to make India where it is today. Dynamic changes in the fields of science, industry, commerce, and especially financial revolution in the approach of PM Modi has been a hallmark in his work as an entrepreneur. For decades, termites like black marketing, like parallel economy and money laundering have been flourishing and eating a country from within. After the introduction of demonetization, these termites have been blown away like an arrow in the bullseye. Demonetization has been simultaneously supported by digital and cashless transactions, making it difficult for the money launderers and bringing the evil of corruption to bare minimum. Government claims that India has been into steady progress after the coming of our new Prime Minister. But at the same time, financial institution claims that under PM Modi and his approaches, our country has been experiencing steady progress and will face steady progress in the years to come. PM Modi, how can we say that PM Modi is an entrepreneur? To conclude, I would like to say that PM Modi has taken his team along with himself and he has made sure that our country reached its possible heights. Just like an entrepreneur takes his team along with himself and makes sure that his company reached its possible heights. To conclude, I would like to say, an entrepreneur does not mold himself according to the environment. Instead, molds the environment according to himself. Thank you.
Is demonetization was only there in India? And you don't know the country's name or particular government name? Now we'll see the list of demonetization in the world. First, Nigeria during the government of Muhammadu Buhari in 1984. Second, Ghana in 1982. Third, Pakistan in December 2016. Fourth, Zimbabwe during the government of Robert Mugabe. Fifth, North Korea during the rule of Kim Jong II in 2010. Soviet Union during the rule of Mikhail Gorbachev. Seventh, Myanmar under the government of Myanmar's military. The government changed its narrative from black money to digital one. But the fact remains the same, that in India, the digital money is far cry because the population is very vast. Moreover, there is lack of basic education. Most of the people are yet to be exposed to internet system and banking system. As there is their total education level rate is 74%, in that 93% has done the primary education, 69% has done the secondary education, and 25% of people have done post-secondary education. And in that, 26% of people only know how to access internet banking. The biggest demonetization in the world took place on 8 November 2016 in India during the government of Mr. Narendra Modi. Now my friend Muskan Manglani will carry on further presentation with purpose of demonetization.
Now the purpose of demonetization, RBI says rupees 99% of banned rupees 500 and 1000 notes returned. Now first, Reserve Bank of India on Wednesday released its annual report showing the various figures of the demonetized currency, which was returned to the economy. Second, the main aim of demonetization was to crack down on black money, which significantly affect the GDP of economy. But with almost all the money have been accounted for, there are doubts if the government action was effective. Third, the long-term effect of GDP of demonetization has impact on has still debated. Fourth, the government meanwhile has defended itself with the finance minister Arun Jaitley suggesting that just because money is back is not that RBI does not mean the black money holders have not been accountable. At last, Arun Jaitley, finance minister, had a conference and defended government demonetization exercise, saying the real objective of the demonetization was to crack down black money, increase tax base, cashless economy, and digitization. In the long run, there will be more formalization in the economy, said Jaitley. Now my friend Priyatosh will continue further.
Demonetization advantage. The major achievement of demonetization has been help to government for taking up black money. This is a help to government for a better help. According to estimate made by RBI, 3 lakh crores worth in money transferred to bank accounts. Another major demonetization is part of black money funding. The black money for anti-social activities.
Another benefit of people disclosing the income, depositing money in their bank account, government get goods for amount of tax revenue used by needed selection for society. Now, disadvantage of demonetization. The biggest disadvantage of demonetization has been the frenzy created among the people initially. Everyone for rushing and demonetized notes while supply of new notes affected the day-to-day budget of citizens, banks and ATM witnessed long the small businesses improve the finance losses. Another disadvantage of this demonetization is destruction of the old currency. Unit and printing a new currency involves the which are borne by government costly high to benefit. There are use of demonetization. Thank you. Now my friend Ismail.
Demonetization was on black money. Black money is nothing but a plunder of the nation. Black money operators run a parallel economy which shakes the very foundation of the Indian economy. So, at the one stroke, our Prime Minister Narendra Modi has choked the supply of black money stock inside our country. The total currency in the circulation of our country was rupees 17 lakh crore, out of which rupees 3 lakh crore was black money. But with Modi's demonetization move, all domestic black money was deposited into the bank or they have just been simply destroyed. Second impact on demonetization was on our economy. Demonetization had a huge resultant effect on the Indian economy. The cleanup of illegal cash had turned around the economy in three ways. The first way is, first, it had bring more borrowings to exchequers, it had improved the inflation outlook, and it had increased India's GDP. Second, it had received investment opportunities and give a fillip to infrastructure and the manufacturing sector. Third, it had reduced interest rates and lower income tax rate. The third, we can see that the GDP was, before demonetization, the GDP was 6.1%, but after demonetization, 6.7%. So it has increased because of demonetization. Third, note bank politics. Demonetization announcement has come as a shock and awe for the political parties and politicians for whom black money was a lifeline. The pulling out of the old 500 and 1000 notes had helped to make the election process clean and transparent. But it had brought tough times for the political parties and politicians who believe in the idea of purchasing votes for notes. Fourth, real estate reasoning. It said that the real estate is an industry built on black money. As I have told you, that the extent of black money floating around in this sector is huge. According to an estimate, at least 40% of the real estate transaction in Delhi was in black. After demonetization move had curtailed the flow of black money in the real estate sector. This had helped in making the much needed correction in the sector. We can see that before demonetization, 40% of the black money was there. But after demonetization, there is a decrease in prices of land and property. Next is hawala transaction. Hawala is a method of transferring money without any actual money movement. Hawala route is used as a means to facilitate money laundering and terror financing. Hawala rackets run again on black money. According to India Today's report, one of the hawala operations in Mumbai has destroyed currency note worth about rupees 500 crore. Thanks to demonetization, hawala operation have come to a grinding halt and black money has been wiped out from the market. Before demonetization, hawala transaction, it was very much. But after demonetization, 50% of Habala transactions were stopped. Plus, terror financing. Terror financing is sourced through Habala transaction. Now I will tell you how terror financing works. First, they circulate the fake currency, which is routed through multi-layer networks of Habala operators, which are closely linked to gambling, smuggling of drugs, opium, guns, and all other things like arms. And then the terrorists collect huge amount of donations and then route the money through Habala transactions. So this financing is known as the finance terrorism. But through demonetization, the Habala transactions have stopped and all the windows for terror financing have been closed. We can see before demonetization, terror financing was 70 crores, but after demonetization, it was only 17 crores. Before it was 70 crores, but after it was 17 crores. Thank you.
So hereby I conclude my presentation on a topic of demonetization, saying everyone in India is analyzing one question, that is whether demonetization was successful in India or not. Different people, different views, some calling it very successful move or some others are calling it a complete failure. 13 months have passed since Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced on 8 November 2016. The immediate objective of a government decision to recall Rs. 500 and Rs. 1000 note was to flush out a large amount of black money hoarded in cash. And the long-term objective is to convert the cash-based economy into digital one. Fake currency. As you all can see there on board that before demonetization, fake currency was 43.47 crores. But after demonetization, it was 11.23 crores. Fake currency imported to India was a major issue as per the reports of Reserve Bank of India. Approximately 0.007% of Indian currency is fake. No doubt, this figure looks very slim and do not show an adequate potential of harming an economy. But this 0.07% money was used for activities like funding terrorism and underworld. So on this aspect, demonetization is successful and we at least could wipe out issues of fake currency which was used to encourage anti-national activities. Black money and corruption. Black money is a major problem in India. Now after demonetization, most of the currency was deposited in the bank. But can we believe that all black money is wiped out from the system? The simple answer is no. But by economic point of view, all black money was not in the form of cash, but in the other forms like precious metals and properties. So idea that all the black money will be out of the economy is doomed. Even if we are thinking that all the black money which was in the form of cash is now disappeared is also wrong. Because some has been deposited with many other names into the bank accounts and will come back to Indian economy itself. Therefore, demonetization policy failed to pull out full black money from the economy. Excessive cash circulation in India economy outside the banking system. Nearly 12.5 lakh crore cash was deposited into banking system at the time of demonetization. Out of this, only 20% was circulating by banking system. Other was circulating outside the banking system in cash. It could be called as successful if for the next 3 financial years, government is able to retain 60% of this with the bank and rotate same through banking system only. Last, inflation. The inflation that was artificially created by the holding stocks by black marketers got control up to an extent. This has resulted in decrease of retail prices of many essential commodities. In long run, due to increase in manufacturing in India, an increase in supply, the inflation will be under control.